Bienvenidos a Colombia Antigua. La historia es para compartirla sin egoísmo. Es por eso que cada video tiene el enlace y la información de dónde fue descargado. Esperamos que los videos y la información sean útiles para usted.
There's no capital punishment for murder in Colombia. Instead, there's Gorgona Penitentiary. Gorgona has 120 guards. Their job is considered so unpleasant and so dangerous that they take it in three-month shifts. The 900 men they guard are Colombia's convicted murderers. On Gorgona, they don't even have names. They're known by numbers.
Primero, 494, pasito.
590. 7 out of 10 of these men are condemned to spend the rest of their lives here, following a precisely regulated daily routine. At 6 o'clock each morning, the prison authorities give to a hand-picked band of good conduct prisoners the nearest thing to a taste of freedom that most of them will ever know, the privilege of joining a working party outside the prison walls. The little force is limited to 100 men, 1/9 of the total convict population. This is because one government regulation insists that all prisoners are paid for their work, but another regulation allots only a fraction of the money needed to pay them. The working party splits into groups. One heads for the beach. Another group heads for the forest surrounding the prison. Gorgona is 3 miles long by one across, and mostly jungle. The job of these men is to clear it. Under the tropical sun, the work is back-breaking. But for the prisoners of Gorgona, it's considered a luxury. But soon, even this outlet for activity is to be denied them. To protect the island's water supply, the tree felling is shortly to be stopped. The logs cut from the jungle are used to help in building the island's jetty. When it's completed, the twice-weekly police boat will be able to bring supplies direct from the mainland instead of transshipping them to a tender. But few of the prisoners will ever make the journey home from the new pier. The penalty to fall all round the island, but because the state doesn't provide enough funds to pay for more guards to stop men escaping, the prisoners are not allowed to catch them. So, paradoxically, more money is spent buying fish from the outside. Lunch is served just after 11 o'clock in the morning. The routine never varies, nor does the menu. At 11 o'clock precisely, the working parties trudge home again after their five-hour stint. Most of the prisoners on Gorgona are poor Indians, too simple to hatch an effective plan of escape. Besides, most of them come from the mountains and are afraid of the sea and the sharks that surround them. But just in case, they are counted yet again before they can have their midday meal. Then each prisoner is searched for any weapons he may have picked up during the outing. The search is aimed to prevent the prisoners attacking their guards. One of the nightmares for the 120 guards is that one day, 900 desperate prisoners might rise up and mutiny. But even more, the search is aimed to prevent them attacking each other. As the years wear on in Gorgona, the prisoners grow to resent their guards less, but instead, they learn to hate one another more. Every now and then, the hate explodes and there's a killing.
Cuatro, 520.
The search sometimes reveals a spectacular haul of small but deadly weapons. Each of them means a potential murder. The price for being caught with an offensive weapon, 30 days solitary confinement in a cell too small to stand or lie in. After the search, the men join the lunch queue. The time spent hanging about doing nothing is not time wasted. There is nothing else to do with it. The guards on Gorgona are aware of the danger of idleness, but they complain they can't get the money needed to spend on rehabilitation of the prisoners. And they dare not give any more freedom unless they are given more guards to guarantee security. Either way, it comes back to money. For the guards, it means the ever-present fear of a mutiny. For the prisoners, a prospect of lifelong boredom. It's not only with weapons that the prisoners can attack one another. The convicts take turns to prepare the food. And so, to prevent them putting poison into their enemies' meals, the prison authorities have built a specially small hatchway so the cooks can't see who they're serving. The allowance for food, bought in bulk from the mainland, is £100 a day. That works out at just under half a crown a head for each prisoner. Last year, Colombian deputies tried to get the prison grant cut. The justice minister argued successfully it would endanger security. The men in solitary eat squatting. Under Colombian law, a man can't be tried for one crime while serving sentence for another. So solitary confinement is the automatic punishment, whether for hoarding a rusty nail or murdering a fellow inmate. A murder in Colombia is 24 years. One in three of the convicts have committed two or more murders. But for the 800 convicts who can't leave the prison, life holds little but a nerve-wracking monotony that will go on not for days, but for decades. The closest thing to normal life on Gorgona is the visit of the trading boat from Tumaco, the nearest inhabited island 60 miles away. No other ships are allowed within 3 miles. The island could become self-supporting with the help of convict labour. It could generate its own fishing industry and cultivate its own vegetables and meat. But the funds are arranged otherwise, and food is brought from the mainland or from Tumaco and put through the expensive and elaborate business of shipping to Gorgona. Fish are plenty. Once a day, there occurs the one unpredictable event to break the monotony of prison routine, a surprise search for weapons. On this occasion, it happened in the late afternoon. The men are made to undress down to their underpants.
Camiseta, camisa, pantalones y gorra.
Their clothes are searched. All personal possessions are carefully checked through. A mug that could conceal a razor blade. The lining of a shirt could hide a knife. A shoe might have money that shouldn't be there. At nightfall, the 900 prisoners are shut into their cells for 13 hours. For the guards outside, ever fearful of a mutiny, the search goes on. For the inhabitants of this one-time pleasure island, another day is over. A day just like the one before. Just like the one to come.